Hello everyone, I am Dr. Yogesh Pawde. I am associated with Department of Biochemistry inside GS Medical College and KEM Hospital, Mumbai. I welcome you to the second session in this lecture series on clinical enzymology. Before going through this session before you watch this video, I will recommend you go to the playlist on clinical enzymology and watch the first video in which we have covered general enzymology and the properties of isoenzymes, because those basic ideas regarding the release of enzyme and the maintenance of normal reference ranges and the mechanisms responsible for abnormal levels in serum, as well as the properties of isoenzymes, will be required to understand enzymatic cardiac markers, which are going to be covered in this session, and the isoenzymes related to those enzymatic cardiac markers. So I'll recommend you to watch that video first and then come back and watch this video and understand the enzymatic cardiac markers which are going to be covered in this session. These are the enzymatic cardiac markers. Majorly we'll be covering CKMB, that is MB isoenzyme, then lactate dehydrogenase and transaminases, that are serum aspartate transaminase and serum alanine transaminase. These three enzymatic cardiac markers will be covered in this session. So coming to the specific learning objectives of this session, we have kept precise specific learning objectives of this session as, at the end of the session, students shall be able to describe the utility of serum CKMB in clinical management of myocardial disorders, describe isoenzymes of serum CK, describe the utility of serum lactate dehydrogenase in diagnosis of various disorders, describe isoenzymes of serum LDH, describe the utility of serum aspartate transaminase and alanine transaminase in clinical management of myocardial disorders and hepatic disorders, describe individual characteristic pattern of rise, peak and fall of enzymatic cardiac markers. Coming to the first enzymatic marker, that is creatine phosphokinase. It is also called as creatine kinase. Okay, so CPK or CK will be the short form we will be using throughout the session. Its enzyme classification number is 2.7.3.2. Its scientific name is ATP creatine N-phosphotransferase. So it catalyzes the reversible phosphorylation of creatine by ATP. So this is the chemical reaction which creatine phosphokinase catalyzes. Okay, so magnesium ions are required. pH, optimum pH required is 9.0, and it gives you creatine phosphate and ADP. So one phosphate group from ATP is transferred to creatine with the help of this creatine phosphokinase enzyme, forming creatine phosphate and ADP, and pH requirement is 6.7. What are the sites where creatine phosphokinase is present in high concentration? These are skeletal and smooth muscle, myocardium and brain, three major tissues or the organs. Creatine phosphokinase has the highest concentration. It is majorly the cytosolic enzyme and it is associated with myofibrillary structures. Okay. Serum activity is lost due to oxidation of sulfhydryl group at the active site of the enzyme. In the first session, we have discussed what are the reasons for decreasing activity of a particular enzyme in serum. So we have discussed the inactivation of the active site there. Okay, so here the active site of creatine phosphokinase is destroyed or inactivated due to oxidation of sulfhydryl group. Its normal reference range is 4 to 60 international units per liter. Now coming to the isoenzymes of creatine phosphokinase. Creatine phosphokinase is a dimer. Okay, there are two subunits and each has a molecular weight of 40,000. So remember, it's a dimer. Now it's just a combination of these two dimers. which creates three isoenzymes, three typical isoenzymes of creatine phosphokinase. So subunit B and subunit M are the products of loci on chromosomes 14 and 19 respectively. So this B will be encoded by a loci on 14 and M from the loci located on chromosome 19. So B for brain and M for muscle. Okay, so we can remember in that way, B for brain and M for muscle. So these are the three typical isoenzymes of creatine phosphokinase. As we have discussed in first session that the numbers of isoenzymes are given as depending on the electrophoretic mobility of those isoenzymes while they are separated with the help of electrophoresis. So CK1, 2 and 3 respectively, those are CKBB, CKMB and CKMM. So CKMM has both the muscle subunit. For example, we just discussed that M is for the muscle, B is for the brain, right? So both muscle subunits are for the CK3, that is CKMM. So it is the richest tissue is skeletal muscle. Then CKMB, one subunit for muscle, one subunit for brain, MB, okay? And richest tissue is the myocardium. And then CK1, CKBB, right? So BB, both the subunits of brain, and it is found in brain as well as smooth muscle. Now, depending on the electrophoretic mobility, as we have already said, 1, 2 and 3 are the numbers given, and the fastest one is the CK1, so it has got the one number, CK1, and slowest is the CK3. If you compare the mean percent in blood, it is 1% for CKBB and 80% for MM. And if you see, it is the 5% only for myocardial isoenzyme, that is CKMB. So if there is a rise in CKMB because of myocardial infarction, you will see that rise will be significantly more than this 5% of the total CK activity. So if it is 100% is the total CK activity, 5% will be in case of normal healthy myocardial tissue, but it may increase to 10% or 15% in case of myocardial infarction. Coming to the atypical isoenzymes, that is CKMT, that is mitochondrial CK. We have just discussed that creatine kinase is a cytosolic enzyme. Okay. Here the CKMT, which is atypical form, it is coming out from the mitochondria. So this mitochondrial CK exists in between inner and outer mitochondrial membranes. 15% CK activity in myocardium, and gene is located on chromosome 15. So it has a different, entirely different chromosome 15. Okay, so this is a true isoenzyme. Then there is another isoform of creatine phosphokinase, that is macro CK. Macro means a larger molecule compared to the usual molecule of CK. Transiently, in up to 6% of hospitalized patients exist in two forms. So I have put query mark here because this is not a true isoenzyme, these are isoforms. CKBB combined with immunoglobulin G or CKMM with IgA will give rise to type 1 of macro CK, and type 2 of macro CK is just oligomeric CKMT. Type 2 macro CK, that is oligomeric CKMT, is found in severely ill adults with malignancies or liver disorders and in children who have a notable tissue distress. Means what? The synthesis process of mitochondrial CK will be affected in case of these severe disorders like malignancies, right, and a notable tissue distress. But the gene encoding that CKMT is the same. It is the synthesis process which is forming this kind of isoform. Okay, so this is not a true isoenzyme, remember. Coming to the clinical significance of creatine phosphokinase. So serum CK activity is influenced by, these are the factors which affect serum CK activity. CK, not CKMB. Okay, this is total CK activity. Age, sex, race, lean body mass, physical activity, and other less defined genetic differences. You know the tissues which are rich in serum CK activity? Those are smooth muscles, brain, myocardium, and the largest one is the skeletal muscle. Okay, so it is the body muscle mass which decides the CK activity, total CK activity. Then coming to the reasons for increased CKBB activity. BB means brain isoenzyme. Neonates with brain injury and very low birth weight babies, the cell membrane will be premature and which will not be in a capacity to hold the CKBB inside the cell. So it will leak out. Coming to the reasons for increased CKMM activity, so muscle isoenzyme. Obviously, all the muscular dystrophies, then viral myositis and polymyositis, these are the inflammatory diseases. Here, the in case of muscular dystrophy, the muscle tissue will be destroyed. Malignant hyperthermia, then there is acute rhabdomyolysis due to crush injury where the muscle tissue is crushed, and because of that destruction, CKMM activity will increase. And then uremic myopathy, which leads to toxicity of muscle tissue. And hypothyroidism, in 60% cases you will see CKMM activity is increased. Here the typically acute rhabdomyolysis and in case of uremic myopathy, you will see CKMB activity is also increased, but only in case of repair process. After the muscle tissue is crushed and when it goes into recovery phase or in during the repair process, initially the CKMB activity will be increased. Why? Because when tissue goes into repair, it goes into its fetal state, and in fetal state CKMB activity is more compared to CKMM activity. Okay, so when muscle tissue is under repair, it will show you increase in CKMB activity for some time, and once the repair process is finished or the muscle tissue has recovered from the damage, you'll see CKMM activity is more and it will come to baseline later on. Then coming to the reasons or the causes for CKMB activity, obviously all the myocardial disorders will be there: myocardial infarction, congestive heart disease, myocarditis, cardioversion where disease of shock is given to the patient, right? CABG, coronary artery bypass grafting, then cardiac transplantation, pericarditis. So these are the reasons where you'll find the CKMB activity will be increased. Now there is a typical behavior of CKMB: rise, peak and fall in case of myocardial infarction. Once there is myocardial infarction, it starts increasing after 3 to 6 hours. Then it reaches its peak level in 18 to 24 hours and returns to baseline in 36 to 72 hours. Okay, so it takes 3 days almost to reach to its baseline after the infarction process has stopped. But if there is reinfarct, you'll see that there is consistent increase in CKMB activity. Okay, so starts after 3 to 6 hours, reaches peak in 18 to 24 hours and returns to baseline in 36 to 72 hours. So thank you very much. Guys, if you find this content useful for your studies and it gives you a good idea of enzymatic cardiac markers, so I'll request you to like and share the video, and at the same time I'll request you to subscribe to the channel to get notified about the upcoming videos, and please press the bell button so that you get the notifications in real time. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching, and please keep motivating us. Thank you so much.